to provide guidance to mankind.
In this review, we're looking at two XCMG road construction machines, which have been modelled by Yagao in 1:35 scale. The first one we'll open up is the XS333 road roller, and it comes in an XCMG branded box with most of the writing on it in Chinese. Inside we find the usual pair of expanded polystyrene trays, and after some careful knife work we can separate them. Then we can see that the road roller takes up nearly all of the box, and then all we need is the giant hand crane to get it out. The RP1256 is a tracked road paver, and included with this one we have a small catalogue of XCMG models. Cutting the factory tape on this one is much easier, and there we see the model wrapped in soft paper. Once we separate that, we can then carefully lift out the model, and this one has one more item in the box, and that's a plastic pointer tool. There's also some additional protection on this model with a plastic film protecting the paintwork on the roof. No assembly to do, both models are complete out of the box. Starting underneath the road paver, and it is detailed, and it appears to show the structure supporting the conveyors. Just in front of the screed are plastic auger screws. The screed has a metal centre part with texturing on top, and the two side parts are completely in plastic. Looking into the operator's cab, there are plastic handrails, cabinets, and it also has a textured floor. One of the high points in terms of detail is the operator's console, but on the review model the colour match on the side doors was slightly off. Some of the grills are nicely formed, but the unpainted hinges on the model really stick out. The hopper sides are in metal and they have nice graphics, and the plastic tracks have a scraper in front. The hopper rams have a two-stage piston, but they're all one piece, and at the back the roller assembly for engaging the truck is all solid. Now we move on to look at the roller, and there are plastic scrapers along each side of the drum, and the rear axle has got the transmission modelled. The big rubber tyres are mounted on plastic wheels. At the front the roller frame is nicely detailed with graphics, and there are lots of small indentations in the casting. The roller drum is smooth, although it's actually very slightly ribbed, and at the back there are hydraulic hoses running to the vibrators. The plastic wheels have got some simple detailing, and there's a non-functional steering locking bar. The ladder is plastic, but there is some nice detailing and graphics on the counterweight. The best detailing is the see-through mesh grills on the engine cover, and they're also accompanied by some nice sharp graphics. Poking through the cover is a plastic exhaust from the engine. The cab has got a tiny beacon light on the roof, and the mirrors and grab rails are made of soft plastic. All of the windows in the cab have got nicely detailed window seals. We will start with the paver and the hopper sides open and close, but because the two-stage ramps are not fully modelled, the hopper sides can't fold down flat. The plastic tracks are a little bit unusual in that they are well formed, but they can't be rotated. So you can't push the model along as you pretend to pave your desktop. The screed has extendable sides for width, and they pull out reasonably smoothly. You can also adjust the height of the screed, and that function works well on the model with the screed able to hold any pose. One of the more interesting features is the opening engine covers, and they give you a chance to see a bit more of the detail. Although the hinges work well enough, it's a pity they are so unsightly. On we go to the road roller, and the first thing to note is that the angle of steering is quite limited. The rear axle spins well, although there's no up and down oscillation. The big drum is not free rolling because of friction from the scrapers. So if we try to roll it along on a smooth surface, the drum itself won't roll. But you can turn it by hand if you want to. Also, if we take another look at the steering angle, we can see that it is a bit restricted. There are a couple of nicer features on the model, and that is opening cab doors on both sides. And they both open reasonably widely, and they give you a view inside the cab, which is quite detailed. The other feature on this model is that it has an opening engine cover, and it opens as wide as a hippo going to the dentist. Underneath there's a nice plastic engine made up of a number of different components. The Road Paver is interesting because of its scale, but it has less functionality than you see on a typical 1:50 scale model. Overall, it's rated as good. The Roller, on the other hand, is a nicer model. Overall, it has better detailing and looks more realistic, and the big scale gives it an impressive appearance. All things considered, it is rated as very good.